So today we're going to talk about force components with unbalanced forces. So as I said, we're jumping into kind of combining units 3 and 4. Kind of awesome. So here's our standard problem. We've got Mr. Dickey pulling a 50 kilogram box along a surface. We need a little bit more information though, so let's zoom out and drag this up. So if Mr. Dickey pulls with a force of 200 newtons and the friction from the ground on the box is 52 newtons, what is the acceleration of the box? That's really what we're asking, is A equals what? That's what we want to know. So whenever we do a force problem, no matter what we're doing, we want to start with a force diagram, and we want to think about a qualitative force diagram first. So let's drag this back down and zoom in a little bit here. So we're going to need a qualitative force diagram. So we're going to draw our down arrow. Force of gravity from the earth on the box. Woo! Then we know we're going to have the force of Mr. Dickey pulling. Force tension, Mr. Dickey on the box. Not so bad. We've got a normal force from the floor on the box. And then we've got our friction force from the floor on the box. Not so bad, right? Now, we need to put some numbers on some of these forces, because we can. So what do we know? We know that the box has a mass of 50 kilograms, so that means the gravity force is how much? Well, we know the Earth pulls with 10 newtons for every 1 kilogram, so that's 500 newtons. We know the tension force for Mr. Dickey pulling was 200 newtons, because I gave that to you. And then we know that the friction force was 52 newtons, because I also gave that to you. So we don't know the normal force yet, but that's okay. Now, the next thing we need to do is, just like when we did balanced forces, once we put the numbers on, we need to find the components of our not horizontal or vertical forces. So I'm going to do that for our angled force here, and unfortunately you can see I kind of put my label in a bad spot, but it is what it is. So I'm going to find the horizontal piece that goes this way and the vertical piece that goes that way. And my angle, which I gave, let's see, what did I give the angle as? 17 degrees, we will stick right in here. Not so bad, right? So, what do we know? If we want to find the acceleration, we need to know what the unbalanced force is. So which way will this box accelerate? Right? That's the first question. So if I'm dragging it along the floor and it's going to accelerate in the horizontal direction. So it's going to accelerate perfectly horizontally, right? But how big will that be? Well, if it's accelerating perfectly horizontally, then we know that the total of the ups equals the total of the downs, right? But since it's accelerating, the total of the rights doesn't equal the total of the lefts. So let's find out what our forces are here. So if I want to find, zoom in here, if I want to find the, if I want to find this one, I'm going to do what? I'm going to say cos 17 equals adjacent over hypotenuse. Right? So our side is going to be 200 times cos 17, just like we would expect, right? So that's going to come out to 191 newtons. Not so bad. So I'm going to go ahead and write that up here. 191 newtons. All right, so let's do our other one while we're at it. And for that one, we're going to do sine, right? So we know that the opposite side, I'm going to skip some of the algebra here, will be 200 sine 17, which will equal about 58.5 newtons. So we can write that on here. 58.5 5 newtons. All right, now let's just go ahead while we're at it. Let's figure out how big our normal force is going to be. So if I've got 500 down and I already have 58 up, how do I figure out my normal force? Well, if I've got 500 down, I need a total of 500 up. So we know the normal force is going to be less than 500. It's going to be 58 minus 500, right? So our normal force will be 441.5 newtons. But what we really wanted to know so that we could find our acceleration was, what is our unbalanced force? Well, in this case, we have 191 to the right and 52 to the left. If they were balanced, it would be 52 to the right and 52 to the left, but we're not balanced. We're unbalanced to the right. So how much unbalanced force is there? Well, that would be 191 minus 58, right? So our unbalanced force, 139 newtons. Not so bad. Well, what are we looking for? We're looking for acceleration, right? Because that's what we want. What is our acceleration? So we know that acceleration equals our unbalanced force over mass. So acceleration equals 139 newtons over our mass, which was given as 50 kilograms. So acceleration, well, let's go ahead and put our kilograms in there. It's always a good idea to have units. Our acceleration will be 2.78 meters per second per second. Not so bad, right? So again, we solve this the same way we solve unbalanced problems that are not at angles, but we still need to find our unbalanced force. And in this case, we find our components of our not vertical or horizontal forces. We determine the ones that are balanced, like our ups and downs are balanced because it's accelerating to the right. And so then we just compare our right force to our left force to find our unbalanced force. Once we have that, we can plug it into Newton's second law and arrive at our answer for acceleration. Not so bad. Now that we've solved the ever popular Mr. Dickey Dragging a Box problem, let's go for the cart on a ramp problem. Woo! Same 50 kilogram box, but this time we put wheels on it and we put it on our ramp. So there's no friction this time. What's the first thing we do when we solve a force problem? We draw a force diagram. So let's mush this out of the way a little bit and let's draw ourselves a force diagram. So what do we have? What's the easy arrow? Well, that's the force of gravity from the Earth on the car. That's not so bad. And then we need our normal force from the ramp on the car. And then since we have our wheels here, we don't actually have a friction force from the ramp on the car. So this one's a little different. So these are all of our arrows. Now we got to think about what numbers can we put on there. And again, the Earth still pulls with 10 newtons per 1 kilogram. So again, our Earth force is 500 newtons. Now, just like before, we need to find the components of our forces. But on ramps, we don't find the horizontal and vertical components of our angled forces. We find the parallel and perpendicular components of our gravity force. And again, that looks something like this. We find the piece of gravity that is perpendicular to the hill and the piece that's parallel to the hill, like that. Remembering that our right angle goes here, not on gravity, but on our two components, because this component is perpendicular to the hill and this component is parallel to the hill. Not so bad. We do a little geometry to find that our 22 degree angle goes right here. Then once we've done that, we can find our forces the same way we did when we did balanced forces. Let's zoom this out a little bit so we can see the whole thing. So we know that our 500 newtons is our hypotenuse. So we just do a little SOHCAHTOA again. So we say, if we want to find this side, we say cos 22 equals our adjacent over hypotenuse. So our adjacent side, go ahead and grab your calculators, punch some buttons, and we find that our adjacent side is 464 newtons. And then we know that sine of 22 equals the opposite side over our hypotenuse. And so our opposite side equals 187 newtons. So over here we have 187 newtons. And on this side is 464 newtons. Not so bad, right? Now, what do we know? Which way will the car accelerate? When I let go of it, which way is it going to accelerate? I know, sounds like a stupid question, but it's really an important question. The car is going to accelerate down the ramp. Not straight down, but down the ramp. So we know our acceleration is going to be in this direction. Is there any acceleration that is perpendicular to the ramp? Or is all of our acceleration parallel to the ramp? Well, looks like it's parallel to the ramp, right? Well, this force right here is perpendicular to the ramp, as is this one. And since there's no acceleration perpendicular to the ramp, we know that this force is going to equal this force. So if we know that the component of gravity that's perpendicular is 464, we also know that the normal force is 464 newtons. Right? Not so bad. And then this force has nothing pointing to the left. We've got a right, but no left. So in this case, we know that the force unbalanced equals 187 newtons. Not so bad, right? And again, we know that acceleration equals our unbalanced force over mass. So our acceleration will equal 187 newtons divided by 50 kilograms again. Again, 50 kilograms, not 500 newtons. 500 newtons is the force of gravity. 50 kilograms is the mass. These are two very different things. They're similar, but they're different. And then the acceleration then would be 3.74 meters per second per second. Okay, we're going to modify this problem slightly now and do it a little bit different. So rather than these round wheels, I'm going to put some square wheels on it. Oh no! What's going to happen? It's going to have some friction now, isn't it? So let's say that the force of friction from the track on cart is, oh, I don't know, let's call it 100 newtons. All right? So how does that change our problem? Well, first off, I still have this vertical and horizontal component of gravity. The presence or absence of friction will not change that. The presence or absence of friction will not change these components of gravity. They will still be exactly the same. But what we do is we need to add a new arrow. So let's bring our force diagram up. We need a friction arrow, and remembering friction acts parallel to the ramp but opposite the direction of the sliding. So it's going to act in this direction. So we know that force of friction track on the car is 100 newtons. So how does that change our results? That's the big question. this force and this force are still balanced. How about this force and this force? Are these forces balanced? Well, if they were balanced, this one would be 100 instead of 187. But they're not. They're unbalanced, aren't they? How unbalanced are they? That's the big question. This one's 100, this one's 187. All right, who's got an answer for me? How big is the unbalanced force? All right, well, it's pretty easy, right? If it's 100 on one side and 100 on the other side, that would be balanced. If it's 187 on one side and 100 on the other, that means we're unbalanced by 87 newtons, right? So we know our force unbalanced equals 87 newtons. And then this would be the force we would use to calculate the acceleration.